Hey everybody, so today we're gonna be trying out some new products together. I partnered with Sephora for this video, which is amazing and awesome, and I'm so honored, and you guys know better than anyone else that I love me some Sephora, especially when I'm picking up stuff to review for you guys, when you guys request things, and of course, you know, I've just been a big fan of Sephora for a long time. Not to mention, I'm a VIB Rouge, and I have been for the past maybe 2 or 3 years, and I don't know how that even happens every year, but this video is part of the hashtag new at Sephora campaign. It's pretty self-explanatory because all the products I'll be showing you guys are new at Sephora. I want to show you guys some of the new releases pretty much, and let's just try them out together. So here are the products. This video is going to be kind of like an unboxing haul because some of these products I have not tried on yet at all, but there are a few skincare products that I did try on a little bit ago just because I got a full face going on. You see it? You can't put skincare on top of this. I wanted to be able to try this stuff on, and of course I will unbox it in this video as well, but give you guys demo clips. Ooh! The first thing to show you guys is this gorgeous Tarte Rainforest of the Sea Foil Paints Shadow Palette. This thing is beautiful. The front of it has a stone jeweled bedazzled front, and it does have texture. You can feel like the 3D effect of the front of the palette, which is very glamorous. And the back is gold and kind of like a mirror in a way. So when you open up the palette, it looks like this and has this little insert. Oh my god, look how gorgeous these colors are. I don't want to get too close to the camera because it's going to reflect so much. I'm going to give you guys a close-up shot, of course, but I can't wait to dig into these. So the first shadow is called Gold Coast, and this is beautiful. Ooh! Oh my god. That's beautiful. It's like a light taupe color in the pan, but it has like a silver reflex to it. Beautiful. That shadow is calling my name. It looks just cushiony and soft. I love it. The next one is Sailor's Delight, which is more of a raspberry color. Beautiful. Super pretty. The next color is Sea Glass, which is like a darker taupey brown. It's definitely deeper than the first color, Gold Coast. This one has more of like a purple undertone. It's a Sea Glass. Ooh. Oh. This is my first time swatching them and I am very pleased with the color payoff. It's beautiful. So the details of the palette is that it contains 3 warm toned, new formulated eyeshadows. And I've tried Tarte eyeshadows before. These are like liquidy and buttery, which they are supposed to be like liquefied metal on the lids. And the last pan, which is called Stargazer, is a split pan. And there is 2 top coats inside. So the first one is a iridescent top coat. And the second one is a silver glitter top coat, which can be worn alone or layered on top of the other eyeshadow. So when you touch them, your finger kind of sinks in a little bit. Excuse me if I like freak out a little bit, but can you see that? Oh my gosh, we need a close-up. So this is the iridescent side by itself. Beautiful. That was this side, so let's try this side of Stargazer, which is silver. Ooh, that is like a pure silver if I've ever seen one. Beautiful. So you have like a little gold, you got a little silver. So I just popped on a subtle brow bone highlight and a warm brown in the crease just so we can play with our lids now. With many metal or shimmery finish eyeshadows, it's better to apply them with your fingers. So I'm going to try to do so. I'm usually more of a brush girl because I'm kind of uncoordinated, but wish me luck. And these do apply so well with the finger. So I would advise that. I think I can even see a little bit of Gold Coast in my inner corner right now. So before we blend everything out, I think I'm gonna pop Gold Coast in with my pinky. I like the mirror on this palette a lot, I really do. Can you guys see that? But the fun part, of course, is the top coat. So I'm gonna take the iridescent side now, and you can even see a little bit that there's a little dent from my finger. I'm gonna put that. Oh, wow. It totally changes the look. Got a little carried away, but can you guys see the difference? Like, whoa. This is pretty cool, guys. I have to admit, this is pretty cool. I like the result of it. It's different. It almost is like a golden eye now, like a bronze. I don't even know, but it's pretty. I like this. I would wear the raspberry shade probably on my lower lash line if I wasn't like picking up my kids from school later. And if I was going somewhere, you know, that I wanted to have like a pop of color. This raspberry is so pretty. So I just popped on my liner and some lashes to complete the eye look before we moved on. And now we're gonna play with some new lip products from Marc Jacobs. These are the liquid lip crayons and I have them in three shades. I have shade 300 Send Nudes, 310 Night Moth, and 350 Femois. But that's the three shades that I have. So these are liquid lipsticks in crayon form. So when you take them out of the box, there is a sticker that says snap shut. So you have to make sure these are closed when you use them. But it's a beautiful packaging, very sleek, and you can see the color. I can see what they mean by snap shut. You do need to push down till it's fully closed, otherwise it kind of springs back up. So keep that in mind. Beautiful. Beautiful. So the crayons have a ghost pearl in them, which is supposed to give them a sheen and a dimensional lip. We're gonna try out 300 Send Nudes first. It glides on like water. It feels like nothing. You can also twist for more product, as you can see, and then twist it back down. So this is shade 300 Send Nudes. It looks really cute. It's not as nude as I thought it would look. It definitely looks more of like a muted red on me, but it's pretty. It looks good with the eye makeup, which I like, and it feels really good on. It feels like I'm not wearing anything, which could be a little dangerous because I could forget that I have this color on, but very, very comfortable. Definitely not what I was expecting out of a crayon, because I've tried a lot of crayons in the past and usually they don't feel this liquidy, if that makes sense. Next, number 310 Night Moths. So this looks a little bit more multi-dimensional than the first one does, in my opinion. The first one definitely looked like a mauve-y red, while this has like a sheen. You can definitely see like almost like a duochrome pink in this color. And the last color I have for you right now is 350 Femois. These lip crayons glide on so effortlessly, like if I am not paying attention, I could totally get this everywhere, but it's so pigmented and it's more of a fuchsia pink. So I decided to put on 300 Send Nudes again because it was my favorite, and now I can definitely see this. All of the colors of course have this sheen, almost like a subtle pearl to it. So I definitely can see that now. I don't know what type of pearl this is specifically, but I can see that there is one. Maybe it is like that undertone that I'm noticing color wise Next two products are skincare. So the first one's by Glam Glow, and this is their new glitter mask. Hashtag glitter mask. Look at the packaging. Extravagant. The glitter mask is basically their gravity mud mask, which is usually silver in a glitter form. It's a peel-off mask, so it's the same firming treatment mud mask that they have already, but this one has glitter! Perfect for anyone who wants to be a unicorn. It's very liquidy. I am a big fan of the Glam Glow peel off. I've already finished the whole jar of it. It also comes with a little brush when you open the box, and it's perfect for applying the mask, and it washes off well. I've already used this brush, and as you can see, it's still like stark white. And you would think the glitter would interfere with the mask, but it doesn't. You don't feel it on your face. It doesn't feel like anything's like annoying you while it dries. It dries well, it peels off well, and it definitely still has a nice result of firming and lifting the skin. And it's a very fun, pretty mask that you can use like on a girl's night in type of thing. How it works is you apply it on your face, you apply a nice even layer, and you wait about 20 to 30 minutes, and then you just peel it off. And I always play a little game where if I can get it off in one peel, then it's a good day. I had one little spot which kind of tore on me because it was like a little thicker on that area, which is like a user error. I kind of applied a little too much on that spot, but I peeled off as close to perfect as I could get it that day, and I think I still deserve a little pat on the back. Thumbs up this video if you do enjoy trying to peel off your mask all in one go. It's just like pleasing, oddly satisfying. The next skincare product is exciting because I've been getting into a lot of Kate Somerville, and this is a new product from her. This is the Tight In Cryogenic Tightening Gel for your face. On the bottle it says it's inspired by cryogenic technology, which I actually have gone to a center that uses like machines for this technology to kind of like freeze your body for a minute, and it's supposed to firm and tighten and also heal in recovery. And I did it more for the recovery base because I injured my leg, but anyway, that was my experience with it, and it was really cold. So when I saw this, I was like, oh, it's gonna be cold. So if you can see the applicator, it has a push applicator and you use this in the morning and night, and it's a last step to your skincare regimen. You put a small amount into your fingertips and you massage it into your skin and avoid your eyes and your lips. And you can wear this before applying makeup. It will feel very cold when it's first applied, but it will tighten your pores and also hydrate the skin. So a little bit goes a long way, as you can see. And it bubbles, and you can hear it kind of popping. Hopefully you can hear that. And as you massage it into the skin, so that was enough for my whole face, that little blob was enough for my whole face. As you massage it into the skin, you'll see that your skin looks firmer, a little younger looking, and it hydrates. And it will feel a little tacky as it's drying the skin, but once it's completely dry, it leaves your face with such a smooth base. I did this earlier this morning before applying my makeup, and I've been using it morning and night since receiving the product because it feels so good on the face. It almost feels like you're wearing a primer that smooths it out, and your skin just feels and looks good. So now it's already dry. It doesn't take too long at all, and I could go on and apply my makeup if I would like to without any sort of like tackiness, which is very nice. But it does feel really good on, and it definitely is cold, and you have to be a little careful when you're using the applicator because sometimes it can get away from you. But all in all, I thought this was really innovative. I don't think anything else I've seen in store does this, so I think it's pretty cool. It is also oddly satisfying because when you're rubbing in your face, you feel it popping and the bubbles are like tingling, and it's like a cool noise. The last product is this perfume by Stella McCartney. This is the Peony Perfume. Parfume? Perfume. Depends on how you say it. Perfume? Parfume. So my favorite perfume that I own, and I own a couple, and this is the only perfume, I think, or one of the two perfumes I own in full size, is by Stella McCartney. And it is not this scent, obviously, because, well, now it is. But this scent is new, but the one that I used before was the more lychee-based one, and I think it's just called, like, the Edu Toilette Parfum, like that's just how it's called on the website. And it's like a clear polka dot pink bottle, and it smells like lychee, and my husband loves it because I wore it all the time when we first started dating. So every time I wear it, he always comments on it. It's my favorite bottle. I think I have maybe like a third or a fourth of it left. But what? So when you open the box obviously matches the bottle. This looks so luxe. It has like a little ombre gradient. You can see that's clear at the bottom, which this does not look like the bottle that I was just talking about at all, aside from the shape. The shape is the same because Stella McCartney always uses like the same shape. It's like her signature bottle, which I like. It's very classy and modern and chic. But this one has like a coral, I would say coral red gradient to it. And it has the signature Stella on the bottle cap. So it says that this perfume is a reinterpretation of a 2006 Stella Into fragrance, and it celebrates the modern, spicier style of Stella's Eau de Parfum. It has notes of peony, rose, pepper, and amber. So let's give it a go. YouTube, get to work on smell-o-vision. We need smell-o-vision. We're just gonna commit. You have to let fragrance kind of settle for a bit, and usually it kind of mixes with the smell of, you know, your body and such. But I like this. Like, it's not heavy. I don't like heavy scents. I would say this one is definitely like mature compared to the other scent that I was just mentioning. But I like this for this time of year. Like, I would wear this to family holiday parties. I think it smells really good, and it doesn't smell too spicy to me at all. I don't pick up on like a crazy amount of spice. Granted that I'm not like the best at smelling perfumes, I think it smells really good, and I would wear this for sure. I do smell the rose and the peony and the amber for sure, because right when I hit like the rose note, which is to me the main note that my nose picks up, I smell a little bit of amber right after, and I like that a lot. This is nice, and this is a huge bottle. This is the 3.3 fluid ounce, which is the largest size Stella McCartney perfumes come in. I have a 1 ounce, which is about like this tall with the cap, and they also have smaller ones as well. And this is definitely going on my perfume shelf. those are all the products for today's video. I hope you guys enjoyed watching it. If you haul any of the products shown in this video or any new products in general, please add the hashtag new at Sephora to your post so you can share with the world, including myself, because you guys are who keeps me up to date with new releases. Honestly, it's really you guys. Thank you guys so much. But yeah, sharing is caring. So add that hashtag to your post if you're posting. Big shout outs to Sephora again to partnering with me. I feel so honored. Thank you guys so much again. Hit the notification bell if you haven't yet so you don't miss any of my uploads. Please comment, rate, and subscribe, and I'll see you guys in a later video.